Sydney is on edge after its second major stabbing attack in just a few days. The latest declared a terror incident after a teenager stabbed a bishop and others at an Assyrian Orthodox church, the incident sparking angry riots. Tensions were already soaring following the deadly mass stabbing at a Bondi Mall on Saturday, with more new details on the killer emerging. Australia correspondent Aziz Al-Safin reports.
Angry crowds, thousands strong in West Sydney, demanding to see a 16-year-old boy officially declared a terrorist. Not long before, inside this Assyrian Orthodox church, the teen storming a live-streamed mass, the bishop stabbed, along with several others. The attacker restrained, with injuries to his hand. The injuries of the people he attacked, serious but not life-threatening. But the scene outside, menacing. Unable to enter the blockaded building for more than 3 hours, their rage turned on police and paramedics.
People used what was available to them in the area, including bricks, concrete, palings, to assault police and throw missiles at police.
At least two officers were injured.
Why is protecting this terrorist for? Bring him out here!
Police quick to call it an act of terrorism.
We believe there are elements that are satisfied in terms of religious motivated extremism.
Amid calls for calm.
There is no place for violent extremism. This is a time to unite, not divide as a community and as a country.
Walking these streets, you get a true indication at just how violent these riots were. Rioters getting their hands on any kind of items to use as weapons. 20 police cars were damaged in the process. 10 of them were written off.
And new details are emerging on mall mass murderer Joel Couchy. Police say he visited two other shopping centres before his attack, and this woman says he confronted her at the storage unit where he was living.
He was halfway in, he was coming at me quite fast, and I just put my hands up, yelled at him.
His parents talking about why he may have been targeting women.
He wanted a girlfriend, and he's got no social skills, and he was frustrated out of his brain.
This is a parent's absolute nightmare when they have a child with mental illness, that something like this would happen.
A nightmare too for the families of the 6 people he killed.
When you're seeing these sort of things, so people...
Sydney working out how to move on after days of horror.
And Aziz is with us now from central Sydney. Let's look at the church stabbing, Aziz. What do we know about the teenager?
Kia ora, Simon. Look, we know that he was well known to police, that he was previously charged with a range of offences in January, including possession of a flip knife, intent to commit an offence, as well as stalking and intimidation. And we can reveal at the time of last night's incident, he was on a good behaviour bond.
All right, let's pivot away from the stabbings. Let's go back to the breaking news about a suspected mushroom drink poisoning. What more can you tell us about this?
Yeah, well, we know that police are investigating a suspected poisoning at a wellness retreat in Victoria. A 53-year-old woman has died. It's believed that she fell ill after consuming a drink. And as you mentioned earlier, we know of at least 2 others who are currently in hospital. This comes after authorities warned residents in Victoria of poisonous mushrooms growing across the state. And this isn't the first time we've heard of poisonous mushrooms across Victoria. You'll remember the case of Erin Patterson of Leon Agatha. She is due in court next month, charged with 3 counts of murder and 5 counts of attempted murder following a fatal beef Wellington meal she cooked for her family.
Indeed. In Sydney tonight, Aziz Al-Safin, thank you.